If Warzone 2 is lagging, stuttering, or crashing on your PC, then we know how to fix it. Simply watch this video till the end and learn how to solve the issue. Hey, you're watching Silicophilic, the home for all tech users. Lagging, stuttering, or crashing has been frequently reported about Warzone 2.0. Here we have shown how to fix these issues. So simply watch till the end and perform the steps as shown. Before we get into the solution, subscribe to our channel for future tech support. Now, let's jump into the solutions. Method 1. You first need to tweak the in-game graphics settings, especially if you are playing on a lower-end PC. Open Game Settings. Open Graphics Settings. Go to the Display tab and set the refresh rate to max. If refresh rate is locked, then change the display mode to full screen exclusive to unlock it. Keep the dynamic resolution off. Set the aspect ratio to automatic. Keep the VSync off. Set the custom frame rate to unlimited. Apply the settings. Go to the Quality tab. Set the quality presets to custom. Under Details and Texture section, keep the texture resolution low. Change upscaling or sharpening to Fidelity Cast and drag the slider to adjust its value to 75. Set render resolution to 100. For anti-aliasing, choose SMAAT2X. Set anti-aliasing quality to low and video memory scale to 90. Keep the texture resolution low and texture filter anisotropic to high. Also keep nearby level of detail low, distant level of detail low. Now comes clutter draw distance. Make sure to keep it short. Keep practical quality low. Particle quality level high. Turn on bullet impact and sprays. Adjust the shader quality to medium. Turn off the toggle for tessellation if it is turned on. Set the Terran memory to maximum level. Turn the on-demand texture streaming setting. Keep the streaming quality to normal and volumetric quality to low. Make sure that deferred physics quality is set to high and turn off water caustics. Coming to shadows and lightning, keep shadow map resolution low. Turn off screen space shadows. Keep shadow spot quality low, spot cache low, particle lightning low. Make sure that ambient occlusion is turned off. Screen space reflections is off. Static reflection quality is low. Weather grid volumes low. For post-processing effects, if you have a lower GPU like the bare minimum and the CPU is not that good, then it is recommended to turn on the reflex low latency. Turn off the depth of field and enable world motion blur. Also make sure to turn on and boost weapon motion blur. But if you are having a good CPU and GPU, then you can keep the world motion blur and weapon motion blur off. Adjust film grain to 25. Next, head on to the View tab. Adjust the field of view from 100 to 110. Choose Affected for Ads field of view. Keep the weapon field of view as default and you can let the rest of the values at its default settings. Method 2. Next, you can change NVIDIA control panel settings to give you a significant boost in FPS if you are using a NVIDIA graphics card. Right-click on your desktop and choose More Options. Select NVIDIA control panel. Choose Manage 3D Settings. Then head on to Program Settings. Find Warzone 2 from the list and here we need to make some changes. If you do not find Warzone here, then click on the Add button and browse to the game installation folder. the game .exe file and come back to the earlier settings. Turn on threaded optimization. Prefer maximum performance for power management. Adjust texture filtering quality to performance. Keep the low latency mode to ultra. Method 3. Another thing you can do is change the launch options as we have shown here. Launch Steam and head to Library. Look at Modern Warfare 2 and right-click on it. Open its properties. In the launch options, type -D3D11. Close it and run the game. If that doesn't give better performance, then change to -DX11 or -DX12. Check each time which one works for you. Method 4. Another thing you can do is check the integrity of game files. From the list of games, right-click on Call of Duty Warzone 2 and open its properties. Go to the Local Files tab and select the Verify Integrity of the game files. Wait for Steam to finish verifying and once done, try to play the game. Method 5. The next thing you can do is add Call of Duty Warzone 2 for high performance. Press Windows plus I button to open Windows settings. Select System and then click Display. Scroll down to find Graphics and click on it. Choose to browse and head to the Call of Duty Warzone 2 installation folder. Select the game .exe and add it. You will see it here now. Click on Options and select High Performance. Click Save. Method 6. Now you can set the power settings to high performance. This will allow your PC to go for a performance optimization over power saving. Type Control Panel on the Windows search bar and click the first option. Change the View by settings to large or small icons if it is set to category. Click on Power Options. Expand Show Additional Plans if you do not find the Hide Additional Plans option. Check the box for High Performance Plan and save the changes made. Method 7. You can also optimize the game by disabling the Steam overlay. To do that, open Steam and go to Library. Right-click on Call of Duty Warzone 2 and open Properties. Go to the General tab and uncheck the Steam overlay option. Steam overlay will now be disabled only for Call of Duty Warzone 2. Exit the window. Method 8. Next, you can set Call of Duty Warzone 2 to high priority. For that, right-click on the task bar and select Task Manager. Click on the Details tab. Right-click on the game .exe process and move the cursor to set priority. Choose High. You can also set the priority of other processes that you need to keep running to low, which should give Call of Duty Warzone 2 more of the system resources to run optimally. Method 9. To run your game smoothly, make sure that your graphics drivers are up to date. Open Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters and right-click on the graphics drivers. Select Search Automatically for Drivers option. After the drivers get installed, restart your PC for the changes to take effect. Method 10. If updating the graphics drivers didn't work for you, Then you can reinstall the graphics driver. Open Device Manager again. Expand Display Adapters and right-click on the graphics driver. Click Uninstall Device and follow the on-screen instructions to finish the uninstallation process. After the driver is uninstalled, let's install it. If you are using NVIDIA graphics drivers, you will need to install the GeForce Experience. For AMD graphics driver, install the Radeon app and run it. The apps will automatically detect the graphics drivers are missing, and it will download and install the required graphics drivers. After installing the drivers, restart your PC. Check for updates again. If any update is available, download and install them. Method 11. You can also close the unnecessary apps and programs running in the background to boost the gaming performance. To do that, open the Task Manager again by right-clicking on the taskbar and selecting the Task Manager option. Click on the Processes tab. Check for unnecessary processes. Right-click on any unnecessary processes and select End Task to terminate the task. You can close programs like Google Chrome, Discord, and GeForce Experience before playing your game. So that's it. If this video has helped you in figuring out this issue, then give us a like and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to comment your feedback on the solutions or if you are facing any issue while performing them. Also join our Facebook group for direct tech support. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching, Silicophilic.